Howdy y'all, my name is Mike, and welcome to my first video. I feel like I can safely assume that if you're watching this video, you might be interested in graduate school. Whether or not you are a freshly graduated undergrad, or you've been in industry for a while, I understand that making the decision to go to grad school can really be a tough one. Luckily, I've broken the issue down to its first principles, and I have a couple questions that you should be able to ask yourself to gauge whether or not graduate school might be right for you. Number one, why are you thinking about going to graduate school in the first place? Who or what led you to make this decision? This is a pretty individual answer you're going to have to figure out for yourself. Personally, I saw it as an opportunity for career advancement and a little bit of a personal challenge. Another common answer I hear from classmates and friends is that it was recommended to them by a professor, a mentor, or someone else whose opinion that they really respected and they really wanted to follow that advice. I will also admit that I considered some programs because I thought Dr. Huff sounded cool. However, I won't sugarcoat the fact that pretty much anywhere you go, graduate school is going to be hard. Knowing why you want to be there in the first place is a really good first step towards making sure that it happens. And as a spoiler, just winning the title probably won't make it any easier during finals time. However, if you've done enough soul searching to figure out why you probably clicked on this video in the first place, then we can move on to question two. Does it make sense for the field you are in and what you want to do? I was a physics major, so please excuse the physics analogy. But your previous experience, whether that be an undergraduate degree or a job, acts as a source of knowledge, and a graduate degree can almost act like a lens and focus that previous knowledge you have into a fulfilling career for the future. However, like any good experiment or design, you have to make sure that what you're doing is the logical conclusion of what you would like to achieve. For some people, grad school might make more sense than others. And to quote Stephen Covey, try to begin with the end in mind. To wrap up this point kind of simply, the idea is to ask where you are now, where you want to be, and if graduate school is the best way to get you there. Now, once you know a further education points you in the right direction, there's one more question to ask. Does grad school make financial sense? In here, the basic question of affordability is assumed, and I'll go into paying for grad school in a later video. Aside from that, though, are two things to consider: return on investment, which I'll shorten to ROI for now, and opportunity cost. In terms of graduate school, ROI is an indirect measurement of how effectively a degree can pay for itself. The simplest way to do this is to figure out how much additional income your salary gives you per year, using something like the Bureau of Labor Statistics, and divide the cost of your degree by the additional income. This will give you an idea of how much a degree will benefit your career. In some industries, like engineering, the salary jump afforded by a graduate degree is pretty high, so it pays for itself quickly. In others, it may take several years to see a return on the money you spent for your degree. It all depends on how quickly you break even. Another question to ask yourself is about the alternatives to grad school. If you weren't in school, could you be working? This is the basis of opportunity cost. It is the cost of doing one thing instead of another. In my personal case, if I weren't in grad school, I would probably have a job. But I forewent that because I expect a good return on my investment for grad school, making the opportunity cost worth it in the long run. This is also another thing you have to figure out for yourself, and if you value that education you would be receiving above the cost of attending. Now, I'll move on from numbers because I realize, even though I like them, not everyone else does. Also, I'm out of questions. I will say that my experience in graduate school has been very positive, and I love the fact that I came to Michigan to pursue a graduate degree. Based off of my experience, I would recommend it, but I would also ask those around you and seek guidance from people who have experience with graduate studies, because they can provide some pretty valuable insights. I know when I was doing my search, it helped a lot. I hope this video helped, and I'll see y'all soon.